Hello, this is Shashi Tharoor, Member of Parliament. I'd like to talk to you today about Vellayani Lake in Trivandrum, in my constituency, which is the second largest freshwater lake in the entire state of Kerala. It's also one of the two important drinking water sources in the city. A naturally fed water body, this lake, over the last few decades, has suffered terribly, losing geographical area. Various factors like encroachment, weeds and so on have completely restricted the space of it, and the lake today is infested with many alien species of weeds like water hyacinth and kariba weeds. These weeds over the last two decades have caused excessive silting, resulting in a drastic decrease in both the depth and the storage capacity of this precious lake. The weeds have prevented the aeration of the water, resulting in the loss of many native species of flora and fauna. The lake is on the threshold of almost complete destruction. There's nothing sadder than a dead lake. Swasthi Foundation, a civil society organization in Thiruvananthapuram, has come forward with a campaign to de-weed, de-silt the lake and implement a bioregeneration of this lake. The government of Kerala has joined hands with this ambitious project called Revive Vellayani, and a request to the central government will, I'm sure, bring in central resources as well. I've championed the cause of this lake in my own remarks before the Indian Parliament, specifically mentioning this lake in my contacts with the then Minister of the Environment. I've been following the progress of this new mission with avid interest, and I'm impressed with the progress so far. In my capacity as the Member of Parliament for Thiruvananthapuram, and therefore for this Vellayani Lake, I've lent my complete support to the Swasthi Foundation campaign, and I foresee this most beautiful lake being restored to its original state through this kind of civil society effort with the adequate backing of the state and central governments. It'll not only be a vital source of drinking water and irrigation for the district of Thiruvananthapuram, but it can also be a hub for cultural activity. It was famous for this in the pre-independence days. Someday, I'm sure, Vellayani will again be a centre for non-polluting tourist activity and a path breaker for other lakes in this area. Let's work together to revive Vellayani Lake.